Hi, it's Janelle from Parsnips and Parsimony, and today I want to share with you my easy, no-cook, fresh salsa that I have been making for years and years and years. And this is a staple to use our fresh tomatoes with every single year, and I want to be able to share that recipe with you guys. Let's start out with the ingredients. You will need 4 cups of ripe tomatoes chopped. You'll need 5 jalapeno peppers seeded and chopped. Now, if you like it a little bit spicier, you can leave those seeds in there. 2 medium onions, also finely chopped, 1/2 bell pepper, 1 cup of canned tomato sauce, 1 teaspoon salt, 1 teaspoon crushed garlic, 2 tablespoons of chopped parsley, and 1.5 tablespoons of red wine vinegar. This recipe came from Jeff Smith, the Frugal Gourmet, and it is definitely a keeper. I'm going to be making a triple batch tonight because I want to pressure can some of this salsa. So I'm going to be cutting up 12 cups of tomatoes. Every batch makes 1.5 to 2 quarts of salsa. It just depends on the size of your peppers, your tomatoes, and things like that. I'm going to be working with a triple batch, which should lead to between 5 and 6 quarts. If I was doing a full canner load, I would do a quadruple batch. When I'm making my salsa, I like to use a couple different varieties of salsa, but you can use whatever tomatoes you have. This is a Roma tomato, so this is not nearly as juicy, which makes a thicker salsa, but I'm also going to be using just a regular slicing tomato. This just looks like something you'd pick up at your grocery store, and I like to mix them. If you only have Romas, that's perfectly fine. I wouldn't suggest using little cherry tomatoes because that's going to make a really sweet salsa, and that's not going to really work all that well for this recipe. But we're going to take our tomato, and we are just going to cut this up into smallish chunks, think bite size. There we go. We'll take another one.
It's a lot faster if you can have some help. So Art is going to help me get this chopped up a little bit faster so we can get this done in a hurry.
There's 8 cups. 4 more to go. Here's 4 more cups, and that makes 12 cups of chopped tomatoes.
Now that we've chopped our tomatoes, we're going to start working on our jalapeno peppers and our garlic. Now, for the jalapeno peppers, I do not like chopping these by hand because they are so hot and spicy, they'll burn your hands.
What I like to do is cut off the tops, and then I take my knife, run it down one side, and that's just loosening that center off. And then usually I'll just pop right out like that, and then I'll cut it a little bit, and then notice I'm not touching the hot pepper. I'll throw it in there to be chopped. I'm also going to add my whole cloves of garlic that have been peeled. Throw those in there. And then I'm also going to be throwing in my parsley. Now, parsley usually comes, at least when I grow it, comes like this. What you want to do is remove the leaves and just use the leaf portion. This is going to save time by just throwing everything in here to get roughly chopped so we don't have to do this with our hands and with a knife. And remember, we're doing a triple batch here. Now we're just going to pulse until it's roughly chopped up. And that looks good. And be careful not to take a whiff of that or else you will be crying. We're gonna add this to our tomatoes. Smells so fresh and wonderful.
A lot of people ask me, am I really sure you don't have to cook this? Because a lot of recipes out there tell you you have to cook the salsa. You do not have to cook the salsa. When you put the salsa in the canning jars inside the pressure cooker, the cooking happens right inside those jars. So you're saving yourself a big step. Next, we're going to be using onions. You notice I have 2 onions here and I'm tripling the batch. When I say an onion, I'm talking a little onion. It's not a huge onion. And these are some giant onions, so I'm just using 2 large onions for our triple batch.
Just cut off the ends and then peel the onion. Just peel that right off like that. Now these are super easy to chop. We're gonna just coarsely chop them. No need for a food processor for this. This is actually faster doing it this way. One more cut right there. That's, if you get a center like that, just pull that out. We don't have to we don't have to use that. And then we'll throw this right in.
Next, I'm going to be chopping up my bell peppers. These are a little on the small side. The recipe calls for a half a bell pepper for each batch. I'm making a triple batch, so I'm just going to throw in a little extra pepper because we like it. And I'll chop this up by hand. If you don't want to take the time by doing it by hand, you can always do this in the food processor, just like we did with the jalapeno peppers. But I like chopping some of the stuff by hand. It just depends on how much time I have and what's going on for the day. So I'm going to remove the seeds like that. And then we're just going to start cutting these into slices, and then we're going to dice them. We'll just throw this right in the pot and continue chopping. We have all of our chopping done. Now we're going to add our tomato sauce. Because this is a triple batch, we're going to be adding 3 cups of tomato sauce. This is just regular cans of tomato sauce that you can pick up at the store. You don't want anything with spices in it, so don't get in the Italian style with the basil and the oregano. Just get plain old tomato sauce. Give this a quick stir, and you can see everything's in there. All right, now I'm going to give it a taste. Now that the sauce is all made, we're going to put in our canning jars. And when you're doing your canning jars, you want to make sure, first of all, they are clean. But second of all, you want to make sure that they are genuine canning jars. Don't use mayonnaise jars, because when you're putting these under pressure, they can crack and cause a big mess in your canner. So always make sure they're a genuine ball or cur or something that says for canning. Before you use them, you want to check the rims for chips or cracks. And how you do that is just run your hand around the top and then along the inside and the outside, making sure they have no chips in them. This handy funnel will be very helpful for filling the jars. And you can pick up a ball canning set right off of Amazon. It will contain this funnel and a couple other handy tools for canning. You're going to fill these up to about 1 inch of head space. And that's because you don't want these to boil up, because they're going to be cooking in the jars and ruining your seal. And I have had that happen before. So this one looks about good. That one looks good. And we're just going to go ahead and finish up this process, and then I'll show you the next step. So the last thing you need to do before you put these in your canner is just wipe down the rims of every canning jar so you have really good contact with your lid and your rim. You'll again want to use a good quality canning lid, and you're just going to place these on top of each jar, of course making sure these have been cleaned and ready to go. And then you're just going to screw these on just hand tight. Usually I just tighten it up like that, give it a little extra turn like that. And if you do these too tight, the bottoms may break out on them, and then you lose your jar of salsa. So there we go. We've got our 5 quarts. We're going to pressure can them for 20 minutes at 10 pounds of pressure.
You're going to put the water in your canner as per your manufacturer directions, and then we're going to just gently place these into the canner. Now we're going to put the lid on and let that steam for a little bit. Let it get to pressure, let it cook for 20 minutes on, we're going to let it cook for 20 minutes at 10 pounds of pressure, and then this will be all done.
So there you have it, super easy, fast, garden fresh salsa that you don't have to cook. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you would like to see a printable version of the recipe, you can check out that link in the description below. Please be sure to subscribe and share this video with your friends, and we will see you for our next video. Bye!